punishment inflicted on the people of Gaza for electing Hamas. These were the first free elections in Palestine, yet the results were clearly found unacceptable to Israel. Renowned US academic Noam Chomsky summed up the first days of the attack. It all started, quote, shortly before noon, when children were returning from school and crowds were milling in the streets of a densely populated Gaza city. It took only a few minutes to kill over 200 people and wound several hundreds in an auspicious opening to the mass slaughter of defenseless civilians trapped in a tiny cage with nowhere to flee. This, however, was only the start of what became known as Operation Cast Lead. In his report to the United Nations Human Rights Council, Judge Richard Goldstone submitted that the IDF's tactics were an example, I quote, of collective punishment on a civilian population for, quote, the election of Hamas, and hence a crime under international law. Shame! Foreign Minister Benjamin Netanyahu has publicly indicated that a ground assault is likely. If this happens, it will probably mirror the 2008 raid, when IDF troops rounded up civilians and executed them in the streets.
Free, free Palestine!
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 Necessities of life have been brutally denied to them through an illegal blockade that we have seen. We have seen them since 2009 use mud to try and rebuild the more than 3,000 homes and dwellings that got destroyed. Illegal settlements. Guess which team has zero illegal settlements? Team Palestine. What Team Israel have? 223 illegal settlements. And we're not talking about tiny little quaint villages. We're talking about monstrosities built on stolen land.
Palestine will be free.
From the river through the sea.
Palestine will be free.
Palestinians have a real threat of white phosphorus. Of possible munitions that will kill for decades to come, potentially. They've got a real threat of being denied access to food and to water and to basic standards of living. And that's unacceptable. And that happens day in, day out, before they send in troops and before they bomb it even further. This is just the beginning, and we're going to need to keep mobilising, because we know that the media will not tell our story and not tell the story of millions of Palestinians.
One, two, three, four. Occupation, no more. Occupation.